basically tactics that we used in the Soviet Union and the late Soviet period were rebooted by Putin. And so the spies actually kind of fell on me. So I had a guy's leather jacket. I don't know if you had this problem, but I had electronic surveillance. So whenever I made a phone call back to my boss in London and made a joke about Putin or mentioned that it's under Litvinenko, I would get a kind of the line would be cut. I'd make another joke like this. So, and my emails were hacked as well. So there was that. And the thing I found most sort of disagreeable were there was a series of demonstrative break-ins at my apartment where I was living with my wife and two small kids. Where, I don't have how the case he does it, they have a three-man team who break in, they can break through any lock. And I took advice from a good tendency about it. He said, there's nothing you can do, there are bugs in your apartment. He said, something he's got this video in our apartment as well, you know, so including in the bedroom. So we were completely surveilled, and they would do things like they would disconnect the heating in the middle of winter, they would open windows, including next to some bedroom, and they would delete family photographs, so we phoned off the hook in my office, so that I could see that someone had been in at 3:58 a.m. and taken the phone off. All kind of petty, but sort of essentially psychological. But it was dark, and it was also quite funny. But the funny thing they did was that I went on, we went on a family holiday together, we came back a week later, they were awfully surprised our friends had said they'd been back. And by the side of my bed, next to the kind of middle-class novels that you will read in English, was a strange book in Russian, which was a sex manual in Russian. And the KGB FSB had bookmarked it to page 132. And so I was sitting there, knowing that, you know, there are bugs there. So I turned to page 132. It's a page on orgasms. How to have a pet orgasm. And I think this is really the most surreal moment of my life. KGB, who are watching my every moment, are now commenting on the most intimate private sphere and suggesting that there's a technical issue or a frequency problem or some kind of performative aspect that they think is humorous. And, you know, it was funny, but at the same time, it was also kind of not funny because, you know, my wife and I, we had no private space, and so we you know, if we wanted to talk about stuff, we had a small garden of plum trees, and we would go and stand next to the plum trees, which only ever gave us 3 or 4 plums, and we would talk about the kids, we would talk about our lives. And I mean, my last book was on Edward Snowden, and we won't talk much about Edward Snowden now, but having been in that kind of environment, I understand that it's why I think privacy is so important for you, for writers, for citizens, for everybody, because once it's taken away from you, it has a kind of corroding effect on your soul. But obviously, these guys didn't care.